Now, I really want to record this rant, and I don't know if this is a good idea or a bad idea or what level of clickbait title I'm going to go for here, but I do have a serious argument that I'd like to make. And it basically goes like this. Stop using .h for your C++ header files. Now, of course, you can hire me as a trainer to come to your company and we can discuss this in person if you disagree with me. So be sure to contact me if you're interested in on-site training or code reviews, and check out the links in the video description for upcoming workshops that I have in your area. I've been doing workshops at conferences this year, and this video is going to air before those conferences come up. So check those out. I'll be at NDC Tech Town in Norway, and I'll be at C++ Under the Sea in Breda, Netherlands. And if you don't know about those conferences already, now you do. As C++ developers, we are honored to contribute to self-driving technology, simplify lives with embedded devices, support financial ecosystems, and assist traders with trading bots. To keep up with the pace of development, we need tools that help us work quickly and effectively. CLion is a powerful JetBrains IDE for C and C++ that makes this challenge its main goal, integrating code analysis, refactoring, and the best ecosystem tools into our day-to-day development. Use CPP Weekly CLion to get 25% off when you purchase a new CLion subscription or renew your existing one. Okay, stop using .h for your C++ header files. Okay, well, I can't find it, but I know at some point in my career, I actually saw a best practice that recommended using .h files instead of HPP or something like that for C++ header files. And I think this is a terrible idea. And if you're the one who wrote that best practice, then leave a comment or something. First of all, if I see library.h, I expect that this is a library intended for use by a C compiler. How am I to know by looking at the file name that this is actually a C++ library? I see .h, I am going to assume that this is a C library. Your tools will also assume it's C. Now, this has been getting better, and so I'm sure some Emacs fans out there will have something to say when I leave my next comment, but way back in the day, I worked on a team where every single header file had to have some sort of magic keyword at the top of it to let Emacs know that this is actually a C++ header file instead of a C header file. Well, that could have been easily solved by not naming the header file .h. Those are my two main points for why, if I see .h, I can't make any useful assumptions about this thing. If I see library.hpp, or perhaps .h++, I don't care. Be consistent, really. Or this one, whatever, fine. I know that this is a C++ library. This is meant for inclusion by a C++ compiler. If I have this .h file and I include it in my C project, but it's actually a C++ header, I'm going to have a very bad time. And to avoid this bad time, you should probably wrap your entire library in an extern C++ declaration so that you don't actually mess up the project that's trying to include your header file. Now, this might actually make sense in the rare case that you have mixed C and C++ in one header file, but I also don't recommend that. And this all stems, first of all, from I want better tooling support, and my tools do different things when they see something that's not just .h. And a significant number of projects that I have worked on have ended up being mixed language projects. So you might actually have in the same project, in the same folder, both the .hpp high-level C++ interface to this thing and the .h low-level portable C interface thing. And this comes from doing all kinds of cross-language bindings and multiple architecture kinds of things. This happens. This is definitely a thing that happens in real code. So I just want to strongly encourage you to stop using .h for your header files that are actually C++ header files. And you'll see consistently in every project that I've worked on, every project that I have that has public code in it, I have never used .h for a C++ project. Not since I was in control of these things. Well, I hope this episode of C++ Weekly got you a little bit riled up and interested enough in leaving a comment. Oh no, that'll probably be a lot of comments. But it'll help with engagement. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly, and be sure to subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next episode.